Very few people may be aware that the Philippines played host to more than 1,000 Jewish refugees during World War II. That's after President Manuel Quezon fought to save them despite great political and personal cost. A new documentary is hoping to shed light on the stories of these refugees who call themselves the Manilaners. Joining us in the studio to tell us more is director Nico Hernandez. Good morning,
Direk. Hello, good morning. How are you?
What an interesting documentary. I mean, coming off the heels of Quezon's Game, actually, which was a very popular movie that just came out. So let's start about the synopsis of the. It's called a docudrama.
Yes, it's a docudrama and it's a documentary series as well.
Right.
So it's gonna talk. We're gonna talk about stories of the three Manilaners. Okay. Their names are Lottie, Max, and Margot.
Right.
They lived here in the Philippines in the 1930s, right after they escaped Europe before all the Holocaust happened. That was in 1938, and they lived their whole lives as teenagers here from 8 to 15.
Right. And they were actually there. Because these the reports at first, it was saying that it was the children of these people who have come from during that time, but these are the actual people who survived it and came over to the Philippines.
Right. So what happened was, during that time in 1938, they called it the Kristallnacht, when Hitler's government was breaking or drawing them away from Europe. So they were already scared and they didn't know where to go. So what they did, they basically planned escape out of Europe, and there were no open countries to receive them. And it was only the Philippines that time that was very much open to welcome them. And that's why we're very much excited to share this story to the world, because this is a history that not a lot of people know. So we want to share that with the world with this documentary series.
Well, you were talking about three different people, but you were saying that Margot and Lottie, they're actually cousins.
Yes, yes.
So I was going to ask you how the attack was in terms of their stories to you. Were some of them a little bit scared or negative about it, or did they all espouse hope?
You know what? When we talked to them, they were telling us that they're like sisters. So they were born 10 days apart, and you know, being away from each other was the hard part, because Lottie had to leave Europe first, ahead of Margot.
With her family.
Yes, with her family. So that was kind of the. A heartbreak for them. So they had to be separated for a month, but then it was kind of a reunion when Margot arrived in the Philippines, which was a happy part for them. So what's also exciting was when they were living in the Philippines, they kind of considered it as a playground, because they met a lot of people in schools and in the streets as well, and they were talking about how they lived their lives in Manila by the Dewey Boulevard. So yes.
And that's why they pretty much call themselves Manilaners, because I guess they pretty much associated with the people in Manila. But where are they now? Are they back in different countries? Are they still living in the Philippines?
Right after the Japanese War, they left the Philippines, because you know, during that time Manila was so devastated and they had to rebuild their lives again. So Margot and Lottie, they had to move to America, while Max had to move to Israel right soon after his military endeavor.
Right. But just as important as these stories of the survivors, because that's what we're going to see, right? We're going to hear their experiences. It's also about recognizing that there was a man who saved them. And this was Manuel Quezon. I mean, I guess my question to you is, before Quezon's Game came out, and even when we remember our history books, Quezon was never associated to helping these Jews.
Right.
Why is that the case?
Well, you know, I think this is, we also talked to some of the historians who helped us in coming up with this documentary.
Right.
And I think it's because of the reason that during that time we were a Commonwealth, and because of the it happened that the Japanese came also, and there's a lot in our plate during that time.
Right.
And that's why we're very, very happy to share this story, because this is a story that not a lot of people know, including me. When I was growing up, I never really heard about this story till I got to encounter the movie Quezon's Game.
Right.
And when I got to actually interview these people, that's the best part of it, because it's kind of educating myself as well in the process of interviewing them. So I think when they see this documentary, it's not only that part of history, but actually learning a lot from these survivors, how they lived their lives in the Philippines and how they enjoyed it and how they were very grateful with the Philippines. I think that's something that we Filipinos should really be proud of.
And when you talk to these survivors, do they recognize Manuel Quezon as sort sort of the hero who saved them from that very difficult and dark time?
You know what? They're very much grateful to Manuel Quezon. They always mention his name. They always thank their families, and they always thank him. They look up to him as their hero, because if not because of Manuel Quezon, they wouldn't be alive during this time. You know, there's this one interview that we had with Margot, and she was telling us that there was this one time that they had a farewell dinner in Europe with the entire family. They were the only ones who's going to leave Europe during that time. And then, you know, after the Japanese War, they already got connection to Europe, and then they found out that all of those people that were in the dinner died because of the Holocaust. Exactly. That was a sad part, right? But if not because of Manuel Quezon, they would be included in that 6 million number that died during the Holocaust.
I guess there's also, it's a tender topic right now because we have a lot of Kababayans in Israel who are facing deportation. Mm-hmm. And some of our senators, Senator Panfilo Lacson and Franklin Drilon, they were hoping that maybe this and Quezon's game could also be shown in Israel, because you did say that you shot some parts in Tel Aviv, right?
Yes.
Just to remind the Jewish community that, mm-hmm. you know, the Filipinos are very welcoming of them, and mm-hmm. they helped mm-hmm. during that very dark time. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, I think that would be very nice as well to share this documentary series with them, and the movie as well. Even us Filipinos, I think we're very much grateful to them as a country, because, you know, when we went to Israel, we saw the Open Door Monument. They even built a monument for us just to thank us because of how we opened our doors to the Jews. And at the same time, when you go to the Quezon City Circle, you see this monument in the circle, and it's honoring how we opened our doors to them.
Right. Well, so such beautiful stories, Nico. Best for them to catch it, right? So how do we catch the Manilaners?
You know, this is History Month, and I think this is the perfect timing. We release this documentary series. It'll be on iWant. Only on iWant they will see it. They can actually just download the app and watch the series for free. So we are launching it within this month. We will be releasing the final release date soon. So yes, and they can actually also watch it together with the other documentary series that we are releasing on the platform. Just last week or a few weeks ago, we launched the TNT Boys, A Journey to the World Stage. And at the same time, we will also be releasing other ABS-CBN documentary made, like Babae sa Balangiga, Mahal You and I, and Radical Love. So those are just some of the titles that we will be releasing on iWant. That they can see for free.
All right. Great things to catch on iWant. Direct Nico, thank you so much for being with us this morning.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button. We'll be right back.